Hi everyone. In this session, we are going to discuss the introduction to domain and range of a function. So, domain and range are really important in the study of function. Let's say we have a function f of s is equals to s squared plus 2. So guys, if you remember what I said about the definition of a function in the previous lessons, I said a function is just like a mathematical machine. I will represent this machine using this bus. So it is just a machine that takes in an input value. So we call this the input to give us an output value. Right? So now, let's say we plug in any number in place of s. So this will be the input. Right? So let's say we plug in s is equals to 2. So whenever we see s, we're going to plug in 2. So this will be 2 squared is 4, 4 plus 2 is going to give us 6. So meaning 2 is the input, right? Then 6 is the output because that was the result we got. So domain is simply our input value. So we call this the domain. And the range is simply our output value. Right? But guys, there is more to it than that. Technically, the domain is a set of all values that we can put inside this machine. So it is a set of all values that we can plug into a function. But there could be some values that we don't want to put inside this machine because those values, they can damage this machine. So we try to get rid of those values. So you might be thinking, what am I talking about? Okay, I'll make this clear. Let's say we have a function f of s is equals to the square root of s. So, now, we are going to plug in any value in place of s, right? So, we are going to input a value in place of s. So, let's say we input 16. So, this is going to be f of s is equals to the square root of 16, right? And guys, if you remember what I said, whenever we introduce a square root, we are also going to introduce the positive and negative sign. So this value can either be 4 or minus 4, right? So now guys, as you can see, this 16 is valid. This 16 is allowed inside this machine because this 16, it gave us a value. Right? So, your calculator can easily calculate this value. Okay. Let's say we plug in s is equals to minus 9 inside this equation. So, this will be f of s is equals to the square root of minus 9. So, guys, can we really take the square root of minus 9? No. If you put this, if you try to calculate this using your calculator is going to give you error. It's going to say it doesn't know how to calculate this value. So now guys, as you can see, minus 9 is not allowed inside the machine. So minus 9 will not be part of the domain. So the only number that will run on this machine is basically positive number. So any positive number we put inside this machine is going to be allowed. Also, we can also put in 0. 0 is also allowed because the square root of 0 is 0. So the square root of any number is going to give us at least any number as well. You understand? So we are always going to have a number for the positive value. And also we are also going to have a number for zero. But if we plug in any negative number inside this square root, it is going to give us error. So now we can say the domain of this function is basically all numbers that are positive, all numbers that are positive or zero. So negative numbers is not included. So the domain are all numbers that are positive or zero. So what about the range? Like I said earlier, the range is just the output. So for the range, just because we can put positive value into the machine, this doesn't mean that the range is all positive value. So I can get a negative value as the result, right? As you can see here, the square root of 16 was 4 or minus 4. So we also got an output of minus 4. So we can have a negative value. So the range is going to be all values on the real number line. That is all positive, negative, or 0. So guys, you can see. So the range is basically all real numbers. All real numbers. So these numbers can be positive, negative, or 0. So guys, this is all you need to understand about domain and range. In the next lesson, we are going to look at some examples.